just to show you these accessorized 4D nails, look. And what it is, you put nail varnish on, and then you you pour over these like little beads and stuff. I'm just reading the back here. Found them in Superdrug under accessorize, and I haven't taken them out of the packet yet. Actually, it's quite a lush little nail varnish there, nice little pink, and then it has these like these beads, which I think are quite interesting. So yeah, I'm going to have fun doing that this weekend. Thought I'd give it a shot, you know. And I'll let you know how I got on with that. I might even do it on video. So you can all have a look at how I cock it up. Yeah, they had all different colours, like green and black, I think. And there was a blue one, whatever. And there's also these other ones that I'm interested in getting, and they're they have kind of like a fluff that you, instead of beads, they have like this fluff that you kind of sprinkle on top of your wet nail varnish. And so they have this kind of like a velvety, feltish type look, which I thought was quite unusual. So if these turn out okay, which is the beads, because I thought, well, I can't go wrong with beads, I might go wrong with fluff, then I'll get the fluff one, the fluffy one. I think they're called velvet nails or something like that. And I'll give that a go. But this one's called Sugar Plum, if you're interested, by Accessorize. It's Accessorize 4D Nails. And there you have it. What else was I going to do? Oh yeah, I was going to show you my watch. I've got this really nice watch. It's by... They call it sexy, but not with an X, you understand. It's that sort of spelling, if you're not familiar with it. And I got it on the way over from Cyprus, and that's my watch there. And I just love it. I love the kind of rose goldy sort of colour, and I like the bling around the outer part of the face. So sweet. But yeah, I got that and I just thought I'd show you because it's just so pretty, and that colour seems to be all kind of in at the moment in with watches, that is, that kind of metal rose goldy thing. So I thought I'd show you that too, because I didn't get around to it, did I? I've been away so long. And since my holiday, I haven't really done a proper show and tell and vlog or anything really. And I have missed it, I really have. But I've really got into my vaping, and I did actually put a couple of reviews and a reason why vaping's changed my life video. I done that in response to a competition. So you can have a listen to that if you want, find out a little bit more about what I'm doing and why. But yeah, I'm really, really into it, and it takes a bit of my time up really, because I'm kind of experimenting with different flavours and still kind of discovering the whole, you know, vaping kind of hobby really. And I'm going to be learning how to make coils and stuff like that, so that I can have, you know, a better experience, vaping experience with flavour and vapour that comes out of the mod. So yeah, so it's kind of taken up a lot of my time. Sapphire, like I said, I think I said in my last videos, she's coming back in December. She's staying for a few weeks, which will be lovely. And yeah, I mean, you know that my video I put out, I did tell you that I'm actually getting married. When Nigel and I were away in Cyprus, we booked our date to get married, which is September 30th, which is about time as well, you know. All the years we've been together, and you know, we've been really wanting to get married. It wasn't because we did want to get married, it was just finances and one thing and another. But my brother and his wife, when they got married in Cyprus in September recently, they inspired us really. They told us how to go about it, and it kind of encouraged us and made us a little bit more enthusiastic and excited about it all. So we took the plunge and booked the day. So we're hoping to, that's what we're heading for, September 30th, to get married. And that's basically our goal, to get married that day. We're hoping that it all comes together. I've already bought my wedding shoes and decided on a theme colour for the wedding. Which is going to be a Cadbury's purple, you know, like Cadbury's chocolate, the purple that, you know, the rag was usually wrapped in. It's going to be that colour with ivory, so quite excited about that. Finds everything in Cadbury, you know, sort of. The reception is going to be small. It's going to be at my parents' house, their new house, and I'm supposed to be wedding dress shopping when Safi comes over. That was my little thing that I was going to tell you recently. That's basically what I'm doing. I'm going to go buy my wedding dress, or at least shop for it anyway. I'm hoping that it all comes together, because it takes some time to find a really nice wedding dress, so I'm hoping that that's what happens. So yeah, we bought our wedding rings. They're purchased. We bought my shoes. Going to be buying Nigel's outfit in a few weeks, I think. So really, I'm going to be also making my own bouquet, because I want it a particular way, and I'm a little bit sort of into crafts and stuff, so I'm going to be using, it'll be a new experience for me, so I'm going to use a little bit of my skills and, you know, crafting and whatever, to make my own bouquet. And buttonholes. What else? Yeah, and all the table decorations and all that kind of stuff that we're going to keep in the same sort of colour theme. And we'll be, hopefully, what I'm hoping I'm doing is just putting them all into a huge kind of box and shipping them over to Cyprus, so that they've got it all there, haven't got to worry about that. Or try and get it over to Cyprus when we go. Yeah, I'm trying to think what else I could share with you guys. But anyway, it's all go, and my son's baby should be born around about Christmas time, just a bit after. I'm not sure. It's the first baby, so it might kind of go a bit later. So that's going to be exciting. Yeah, crazy, really crazy, very exciting though. And I'll be going to the baby shower. She's having a baby shower on Sunday, this coming Sunday, so all goes good, that's what I'll be doing Sunday. And that'll be a giggle, and sweet, I hope. Work is not good at the moment, because the working area is just totally unsafe. We've got neighbours, the winds blew down a fence over the back, and they're fixing it. So that's the noise. Hope you can hear me. But anyway, yeah, so work, the environment is still very unsafe. It's actually illegal. I checked it on the internet, all the details of how, you know, a work surface, a workstation should look, and, you know, the comfort and the ergonomics, and it's all basically wrong. They've got it all wrong. So I am on them. I've spoken to the health and safety officer today, and she reassured me that she's assessed the area, finding if it's fallen short, and that she's taken photographs and passed on information to upper management. who has only just now, I think, come back from holiday. He hopefully should be on it very soon. But I'm going to phone her up in about a week just to see what she's doing. And if she hasn't got anything going, then I will give her another week. And after that week, then I will be have to take a different direction with it. But I won't be letting it go because I enjoy my job, but it's an unsafe environment and it's not fair to me or my colleagues. I have colleagues that never suffered with their back and now suffering with their back and actually can't work on the section. And it's despicable, it really is, that these things, this environment's changed about 6 or 7 weeks ago, maybe longer, I'm not sure, and nothing has been done about it. So that's what's going on at work. But anyway, I've logged it, so it is written down. I've written down what happened to what's said in the conversation. So if anything goes wrong or I need backup, like to prove that I had this conversation, at least it's logged. And also I'm logging it here. So wish me luck on that one, guys, because I really need to get this sorted. So I love my job and I just want to be comfortable and I want to do it to the best of my ability. You know, I'm good at my job and I really enjoy it and I love the customers. Interaction, you know, and I was really happy. I was not having any pain. I could just get up in the morning. I could, you know, I could walk home without being in crippling pain. And also on top of that, I'm taking really strong painkillers, cocodamol, and it says it on the packet that you shouldn't use it more than 3 days, and I've been using it all week because I can't cope with pain. But it helps with the pain, it takes the edge off so that I'm actually functioning rather than just flat out on the bed. But it does make me extremely sleepy and I'm just hoping that I don't get too addicted to them, to be honest with you, because that's what it says in the packet. Can't use it because they're very addictive. But guys, what can I do? I'm in pain, you know. I've tried different painkillers and they've all got these tons of side effects and I just can't cope with them. And cocodamol does it for me, you know. So that's why I sound really sleepy. But anywho, pray for me, those that believe, and wish me luck, those that don't. Because it's going to be tough tackling this. I hope it's not going to be, but I have to go all the way with it, because that's where I want to work, and that's where I do work. And I just want to get on with my job. I just want to be safe doing it. And I want my colleagues safe too. So there you go. I've got a new juice today. I had some vape mail, as they call it. It's called Vape It UK. And I got apple pie PG 50 40, so it's PG and then 40 VG, and I've got 6 milligrams of nicotine. I sit there, it's like an e-liquid apple pie, you know. I can't wait. And when I do vape it, I'll do a review. Exciting. Anywho, at the moment I'm vaping on, and if you didn't hear my last video, I'm vaping on fluffy cake. It's nice. It tastes like cake mix. It's lovely. Anywho, I'm gonna go and gonna go and recharge my battery and my body battery. Take care. Keep it real, guys. See ya.